Before we start, remember to comment on who you want next. And also, MNJTV fans, don't dislike bomb me unless you watch the whole video. Anyways, starting with this review, MNJTV. Okay, we're gonna start with the bad stuff first. First of all, the worst thing on this channel, maybe one of the worst things I've ever seen on YouTube, you know, besides some really dark and negative stuff, is his Pokemon meme reviews. They are just awful. I kid you not, the first time that I watched this, I physically cringed and had to turn off the video, and I was 3 seconds in. And for those of you who are saying, give it a full chance, I did watch the full thing. And to say, besides cringy, it was boring to me personally. And one common trend that I noticed in these meme reviews is that he seemed to be acting kind of fakeish. I'm assuming he was trying to put on some PewDiePie persona or act like him. The problem with this is that it doesn't work. Now, if this was satire, acting like PewDiePie would make sense. And if he isn't acting like PewDiePie, then overall what I have to say is these meme reviews come off as awkward, clunky, and he just acts really unnatural if he isn't trying to act like PewDiePie. Another thing I need to talk about with this channel is he got into controversy a while back. This was during Sun and Moon. And this is basically with Verlissify, where he called him out for clickbaiting his thumbnails. Basically, the whole gist of this was with Alolan Forms, and I guess he didn't put fan-made anywhere, so it kind of just seemed like it might have been official. Unfortunately, I am going to have to knock him down because he seems to be doing more or less the same thing with the Galaforms, especially in the thumbnails with putting things like new in the corner, which is very clickbaitish. And the last thing, his biggest series on the channel being Pokemon Talk. I made a full video addressing my feelings on it. And to this very moment as I'm recording, I say most of my opinions still hold up to be true. I do feel like now they become 8 to 10 minute shit pieces. Shit as in, yes, they are shit, but also it just feels like a bunch of fluff. If you want my full thoughts on that, please go check out that video. Hopefully I remember to include it in the right hand notification card thingy. I don't know what it's called. Alright, now that we're done with all the negative stuff and probably most of the MNJTV super fanboys, you know, did their dislike and left, let's talk about some actual medium to good things about his channel. In the medium, the only thing I really have to comment about that would be his thumbnails. His thumbnails are alright. They're not anything like extravagant or like extremely amazing, but I definitely feel that they get the job done. But personally, I feel there's more to be desired. But overall, they aren't bad. Now, when talking about the things that he does well, I will have to say that his like general topic videos, like where he just covers random topics or just kind of tries to answer like a random question in the Pokemon universe, those videos are quite good, I must admit. They're well edited, well researched, the background music is very good, and he chooses great topics to cover. I really feel like that's like one of the only things he does well on this channel. Now we are going to get into the score, and unlike the last video, this scoring breakdown is quite complex. However, before we get into it, I do want to say that I felt like his channel back in the day, like years ago, was definitely more authentic, and now his content today kind of feels forced. And this is kind of a reoccurrence within all of his videos. I've noticed there's always some kind of forced enthusiasm. I don't know if he's naturally like this as a person, but to me it seems kind of forced and faked. Overall though, I was expecting this channel to be way shittier. I expected worse, but here's what I'll say. These side series like Pokemon Talk and meme reviews are just not this guy's element anymore. While I'm sure there are people that like them, I'm sure there's an audience for it, I just cannot stand them. However, his main stuff like covering random topics and answering certain questions like I said before is actually some pretty good content. Now for the rating, factoring the entirety of his channel, this will be a 4.8 out of 10. Originally, I put it at a 5.6 out of 10, but that thumbnail controversy, and furthermore, not changing it, and arguably getting even worse, knocks him down a few points. Now, if I had to give an overall for like the new MNJTV, like when his channel kind of started to drop off, I would give him a 3.2 out of 10 at best, and the old MNJTV is like maybe like a 7 High 6, Low 7, that's where I would put his old channel. Alright, so my final message is, if you felt disturbed by this video, I'm sorry. If you're an MNJ TV fan, please don't quit watching him just to please me. We're all entitled to wanting different things. And if you can genuinely enjoy this channel that I can't anymore, I am truly happy for you. But my message to MNJ TV himself is, despite me not liking your channel, I have to say big props to you, because I think, in my opinion, you're like one of the first like legit PokeTubers in a sense to like grow to 1 million in kind of like a slow, natural way, and who doesn't do TGC. What trading card game? Did I get that right? Not really sure. Regardless though, Michael, even though I don't like your content, I will say I have tremendous respect for you building up this channel and growing your brand or whatever you're going on with. So despite me not liking your content, keep going strong, keep growing. This goes for all PokeTubers out there, the ones that I like and that I hate. Besides that, please check out the previous Poke review on Weedle to a Needle. Besides that, make sure to watch some more videos. But above all else, have a good day.